humility to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference.
I've been taught to respect my elders and behave. Even if when they were young, they sold slaves. Truth and understanding is what I crave in the land of the thief, home of the slave. Turn your page to a brief demonstration. The now in 90 is strictly information I'm giving. Teaching on a regular basis. Today's lecture is about the racist. We're not out to exaggerate or diss them, but show the symptoms and facts of racism. Understand, the racists ain't equal. There's about five different types of racist people. First of the five different types of cases is the individual brought up racist. Here you have young men and women brought up in the great white way opinion. This opinion introduced by the parent to the civilized becomes transparent. A civilized man could look through the faces, make the analysis and see the racist. Number two case which all must hear is the individual racist out of fear. Here you have people that fear the African and conjure up new ways of trapping them. Number three is the unconscious racist. Not knowing they're racist, they invade your spaces. They say, I'm not a racist, I'm not a bigot. Yet they allow them to go on and won't admit it. Number four is the money racist. The one that used the topics of sheer economics. They say, owning a business isn't for the black man. He don't want that, yet they went and took his land. Damn, that's like a rock in a hard place. You don't have your land, yet this ain't your space. America was built by every other race except the European that runs this place. What a waste. America's doomed to be overthrown by the righteous real soon. But last but not least, racial prejudice is the black man speaking out of ignorance. Whitey this and Ching Chow that. It's not how the intelligent man acts. You can't blame the whole white race for slavery, cause this ain't the case. A large sum of white people died with blacks, trying hard to fight racial attacks. The media wants you to think that no whites really fought and died for civil rights. But once we have a true sense of history, you'll see this too is a mystery. And black and white didn't argue the most. They can turn to the government screwing them.
Let me and my people go.